In this tutorial, we will show you how to design and simulate your first grid-connected project. Begin by creating a new project. The project is a file that contains central information for your system. This includes the location, the reference to its meteorological data file, and some general parameters related to the project. In your workspace, it will be represented by a file with a file name extension of .prj. Within a project, you may define as many variants as you want. Each system variant contains all the detailed definitions of your system, which will result in a simulation calculation. These definitions include the choice of solar panels and inverters, their number, possible shadings and geometrical layout, electrical connections, the economic scenario, etc. In the database, the files representing the variants of a project will have the project's file name with the extensions of VC0, VC1, up to VCA, etc. To start, you have to give a name to your project. You can either choose a site from the database, which holds around 2,500 sites, or define a new site anywhere on the globe by choosing it on the map. We will be using Geneva Contrin as our site. You have to define a Medio data file. If a Medio file is present in the vicinity, it will be suggested. Otherwise, it will be constructed from the site monthly data when saving the project. When the project is ready, you will be prompted to save it. The Save dialog shows the description, which is the name of the project. It asks for a file name. You should keep the file name rather simple, as it will be used as a common label for all the variants in the project. Now we have to define our first variant. Note the central blue panel. It'll tell you any required next steps to be taken. You'll notice that at the beginning, there are two buttons marked in red, Orientation and System. When a button is marked in red, it means that this variant of the project is not ready for simulation. Additional input is required in that particular element. Whenever you define a variant, you need to give it a significant name. In this case, we will use My First Simulation. Now, let's define the orientation. For this project, we're going to use a tilt angle of 25 degrees and an azimuth of 20 degrees. This will orient our panels 20 degrees to the west relative to south. Now, we have to define the system. You may define the desired PV power or the available area. It's not mandatory to define a value here, but this will simplify your first approach, as this will allow PVSyst to propose a suitable configuration. We will set the available area for positioning our PV modules. You now have to choose a PV module in the database. We will use a generic 300 watt peak panel. We also have to choose an inverter. PVSyst suggests the suited inverter power. We will use a 7.5 kilowatt inverter. Now PVSyst suggests a complete configuration for the system. In our case, this includes one inverter with two strings of 15 modules in series. If you get a red error message, there is a mistake and you have to correct the error. You cannot perform the simulation. If there is an orange message on the other hand, this is a warning. The definition of your system is acceptable but not optimal. In the case of an orange message, you can still carry out a simulation. Now there is no red message, so PVSyst is ready to perform the simulation. We click on the Run Simulation button and the simulation runs immediately. This dialog shows a small summary of the simulation parameters and its results. All the information about the simulation parameters and results are gathered in the report. We will go through the report of our system now. Note that if you add complexity and more components to a given variant, the report may show additional graphs, diagrams, and data. The first page of the report is a cover page. The second page shows some high-level summaries of the project, system, and results of the simulation variant. The third page shows all the general parameters of the simulation. The general parameters include the PV field orientation and the shading parameters used. The PV array characteristics tell you everything about the PV system. This includes the modules as well as the inverters. Array losses give you an overview on the settings used to calculate the losses in the PV system. The fourth page shows the main results. The graphs at the top show you the normalized production of the system and the performance ratio over the year. The normalized production shows collection and system losses as well as the useful energy produced per kilowatt peak of the installed PV modules. This is paired with a graph of the performance ratio for each month of the simulation. A table showing the balances and main results for each month, as well as the whole year, is also given. Page 5 presents a Sankey diagram of all the energy fluxes to represent all the losses in the PV system. This is a powerful indicator of the quality of your system and will immediately help you to identify sizing errors, if any. Page 6 shows some special graphs of the simulation. In our simulation, you can see that the daily input-output diagram and the distribution of power injected to the grid are shown. We can export our report in various ways, such as a PDF or printing directly. If we click on the Export button, then we can see many options on simulation results that can be copied to the clipboard. This should be used when comparing several simulations. You can also export it as an image on the clipboard for comparing in other software like Excel. We now come back to the system and analyze a tool which helps for the sizing of the array. A first graph shows the voltage constraints, which will determine the number of modules in series. Here you have the PV array IV curves for winter conditions, i.e. the high voltages, and for the summer conditions, i.e. low voltages. The graph shows the lower and higher voltage limits of the maximum power point tracking, or MPPT. The MPP values of the IV curves should lie between these limits. You see also the maximum open circuit voltage at lower temperatures. This should never exceed the absolute maximum voltage allowed for this inverter. You can play with the number of modules in series in the system to see how this affects the maximum open circuit voltage. You see also the input current and power limitations if these are specified for this inverter. Don't worry about this too much. These are not really significant, as the inverter takes care of its own limitations during operation. We now have to decide the number of strings in parallel according to the array power required. For this, PVSYST shows the distribution of effective power available at the output of the array during the whole year for your medio data and the plane orientation. Here we have the nominal power at the input of the inverter. The operating conditions above this value will be limited. The violet curve shows you the limited power, and the green curve shows you the available power from the array if the array is working at its maximum power point. The difference between these curves represents the overload loss. The area between these curves with respect to the full histogram area is the overload power loss percentage. PVSYST considers your sizing to be good when the overload loss doesn't exceed 3%. When the overload loss is between 0.1% and 3%, PVSYST considers a slightly undersized inverter and puts an orange warning. However, if the overload loss exceeds 3%, PVSYST gives an error message in red, and then the simulation will not be possible. If you want to create systems with a highly oversized PV array, you can increase the limit of 3% in the project settings. An important indicator is the nominal power, or PNOM, ratio. This is often called the DC-AC ratio. A good sizing usually corresponds to a PNOM ratio of between 1.25 and 1.3. Note that the overload loss calculated by the simulation may be significantly different from this sizing value. This is because the calculation of the histogram for this rough sizing tool cannot take all the system losses into account. The reference result will of course be the result to the detailed hourly simulation.